A very warm welcome to all of you to our channel, and in this PowerPoint animation tutorial you will not only learn how to animate a JCB machine but also learn how to define long motion paths to separate parts of a body without any glitches. The animation is inspired by the work Vivek Chowdhury at dribble.com. First, let's take a look at the selection pane from the Home tab to see all the objects we used in this presentation. The JCB machine has been drawn using different shapes from the Shapes tool of Insert tab and later has been grouped into a total of 5 parts: back tire, body and front tire, bucket, loader, and tire marks. The JCB machine has been placed outside the slide area as we want it to move in during the slideshow. If we open the animation pane from the Animations tab, then you can notice that a total of 9 animations have been applied. 4 of them are spin effect and 5 are motion paths. We are repeating all the spin effects until the end of the slide but not repeating the motion paths. If we delete all the motion paths and place the machine in the middle of the slide, then it will continue to spin all the parts but at the same position. If you don't want to move the machine, then you can move the background instead as we did on the second slide, where 3 different mountain group shapes and clouds are moving to the left and the machine is standing still at the same position. It creates an illusion as the machine is moving to the right. To move more than one JCB machine during the slideshow, you can make a duplicate and then place right it on top of the previous, and the red guides will help you to identify the exact position. Now, just add a delay timing of 7 seconds to the duplicate effects and there you have 2 machines one after another. If you also repeat the motion paths until the end of the slide, then the animation will get changed as the first machine will start following the second one. Now, let's talk about the spin effects into the bucket. We have applied to spin effect with 15 degree clockwise rotation with auto reverse. The time duration of this effect is 0.75 seconds, and the same duration has been applied to the end smoothness. The front tire has been attached to the machine's body and we are spinning this group at 1 degree counterclockwise with auto reverse with a short time duration of 0.25 seconds. Then the back tire is rotating at 360 degrees clockwise with a time duration of 2 seconds. We are rotating the loader 8 degrees clockwise with auto reverse and with a time duration of 0.75 seconds, and the same duration has been given to end smoothness. Now, we will apply the motion paths again from scratch, and this technique of defining long motion paths to separate objects will also help you in other projects. So, if we select all the 5 group objects and apply the right motion path and see the slideshow, then it will work fine as all the parts will move together at the same distance. But what if you want to increase the length of these motion paths? If you will increase the length of one motion path, then another motion path's length should also match with the previous, otherwise, the machine will seem broken during the slideshow. For instance, if we increase the length of bucket's motion path and place it outside the slide, and when we try to increase the length of the body and front tire, then we do not exactly know what the exact length should be to match it with the bucket. If both the motion path lengths do not match, then the animation will seem broken during the slideshow. The workaround to this problem is to select the bucket motion path from the animation pane and then hold down the control key while selecting the body and front tire motion path. That way you will start seeing the end position of both of the shapes. Now just increase the length of the body and front tire motion path and place it right at the position to attach it with the bucket. You can repeat the same steps to adjoin the other parts like the back tire. Now, select the body and front tire motion path effect from the animation pane first and then hold down the control key while selecting the back tire motion path. Repeat the same procedure to attach the loader with the body and front tire and do the same for the tire marks. That is the only way we found out to match the motion path length of separate parts of a single body, and hope you will find this technique useful. Now, if you also want to move the JCB machine from right to left, then first make a duplicate and place it on the right side of the slide. You now need to make a group of all these separate 5 parts into one and then flip them horizontally through the shape format. Without grouping them in the first place, if you will try to flip them, then it is not going to work. But you will also be going to lose all the animation effects after grouping them. You must reapply all the effects, and you can take the help of Animation Painter to replicate the effects, but first, you again need to ungroup them into 5 separate parts. To replicate the effects, for instance, select the top bucket first and then click the Animation Painter once, and then click on the bottom bucket. Repeat the same steps to replicate the other effects of the top JCB machine to the bottom machine. But you again need to apply the motion path from scratch, as the top machine is moving left to right and we want the bottom machine to move from right to left. You can again follow the same procedure as we did before by selecting 2 motion paths at once to match their position through the animation pane. Finally, to make this animation of a longer duration and to run it in a loop, you do not need to create duplicate slides. Just move to the Slideshow tab and then click on Setup Slideshow. Here make a checkmark on the loop continuously until the Escape key is pressed, option. Run the slideshow, and there you have a JCB machine running from left to right and right to left, one behind another. I hope you will find this tutorial informative and interesting. Let me know what you think by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel, as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.